Mark Stoff from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2352. Highlight the top row for each ID. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Question today from Sowmiya on YouTube. She has several different IDs. ID 1 has a lead count of 6, 9, and 10 in different dates. ID 2 has lead count of 15, 10, and 9 in different dates. Wants to highlight the row, the entire row, with the top lead count for each ID, right? So this is the formula that I sent. And so Mia says, no, I have 250 of these. I get it. When you're creating conditional formatting, the way to do it is don't try and build it in the conditional formatting dialog box. Build it outside the conditional formatting dialog box. All right, so the formula here, let's make it larger. I have data today in rows 2 through 23. If you have 250 of them, sure, I get it. It goes to a larger amount, but make the formula be larger. So the MAXIFS, we're going to look through all of the lead counts in B2 to B23. This is what we're taking the max of. The criteria is look through A2 to A23 and notice that there's $1, $2, $3, $4 signs there, $1, $2, $3, $4 signs there. The most important part is the third argument. When you're creating conditional formatting, you have to be writing a formula as if it applies to just the cell that you're in, right? And I want to say if dollar sign A, always look in column A, but the 2 has no dollar sign. That means that it's allowed to move. So just imagine, as this gets copied down, it's going to be pointing at different rows. And same thing here, dollar sign B2 will say, from among all of the things with a lead ID of 1, if this item is the max, so B dollar sign 2 is the item in this row, is the max. And here we'll just take a look at this formula as we copy it down. So we come down here. See, in the formula, the B2 to B23 stays, A2 to A23 stays, but the A2 is changed to A11 because there's no dollar sign there. And the B2 changes to B11. Once you have that formula working, then you're going to put the thing in edit mode with F2, select all of the characters in the cell. Don't copy the cell. You have to do it in either from the formula bar or in edit mode. Control C to copy. And then clear the rules, select all of your data, making sure that A2 is the active cell, conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format, and then control V. Be very careful in this box. If there's a mistake and you press the left arrow key, it's going to start adding cell references because down here we're in enter mode. If you press F2, then you're in edit mode. You can move left and right in the box and then format. Just choose whatever format you want. I'll choose a nice light color like that. Click OK. Click OK. And now for ID 1, 21 is the largest, and the whole row gets highlighted. These don't have to be in any particular sequence. This can be in date order, and it's still going to work. Change one. Let's take ID 1 and change it to 99, so it's the largest. See, and it changes, right? You don't need these out here. You just use those as a helper to help you build it and make sure it's working before it goes on. All right, Sowmiya, hopefully that helps. Please, for everyone, Sowmiya, everyone, subscribe and ring that bell. I'm trying to get a better merch experience down below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly. Click the I in the top right-hand corner for more information about that. Well, hey, thanks to Sowmiya for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Mr. Excel.com.